First, let's see what data veracity is. There are different takes on what veracity refers to, but the overall consensus is that data veracity reflects the truthfulness of a data set and your level of confidence or trust in it. I'll take this a step further and say that data veracity is your level of confidence or trust in the data based on its provenance, so its source, the data processing method, its context, and how meaningful and suitable it is to the analysis you want to use it for. Think about this. When you get a box of chocolates, which you haven't tried before, how do you estimate how good that chocolate is? Well, the first step is to look at where it was made. Wow, a collection of fine Belgian chocolates. Sounds good. So you look at where it was made, right? But what shop or brand or even what country? And you can mainly assess its quality by its provenance. That's that first step. As a second step, you probably also want to ensure that after you open the box, you won't taint the chocolate somehow before you're going to taste them. Lastly, you want to see if it's suitable for how you want to use it. So it would be a great dessert. Chocolate is always a winner, but not so much as a main course, though I might be able to eat a soup of melted chocolates. Okay, that's chocolate fondue. Though soup of melted chocolates has a certain appeal to it, doesn't it? If you like this video so far, or chocolate fondue, please click the like button and don't forget to subscribe to the channel by clicking on the subscribe and bell buttons. And that way you'll be able to know when I'll post a new video. So why is data veracity important? Well, according to an Accenture Technology Vision 2018 survey, 82% of executives state their organization are increasingly using data to drive critical and automated decision-making at unprecedented scale. Meaning? Well, meaning that data is now playing an integral part of decision-making and strategy building in industries such as healthcare and retail and marketing, supply chain, manufacturing, oil and gas, education, and so many more. But it is of no use to anyone if it is data that we don't trust for its intended use. I don't think that anyone downloaded an industry report off the internet or just purchased a data set and used it to take action without first gauging its veracity. Data veracity helps us better understand the risks associated with the analysis and business decisions based on a particular data set. Looking at a data example, imagine you want to enrich your sales prospect information with employment data, such as where those customers work and what their job titles are. Not only this can provide you with an additional contact data, but it can also help you create different market segments and do a better job at serving these customers. LinkedIn collects lots of employment data, as you know, but unfortunately you can't purchase it from them. So what can you do? Well, you might go to another third-party provider who claims to scrape LinkedIn data from search engine results, a legally gray area, in my opinion, at least at the time of this video, but I'm not a legal expert, so let's just treat this as a theoretical example. So you might consider purchasing this LinkedIn employment data, but how do you gauge its veracity? Well, there are a set of questions I always recommend going through, and I encourage you to watch the video where I go over these questions right after this one. To expand on this employment data example though, what if your customer base only included lawyers? Well, then you wouldn't choose LinkedIn as your data source, but rather go to the American Bar Association. Why? Well, because the bar associations have a higher data veracity for this type of data than the one that is self-reported, such as the one from LinkedIn. We should also keep in mind that veracity is impacted by human bias and error, lack of data governance and data validation and software bugs, which can lead to duplication and variability and volatility of data. We all wish for these to be addressed as we consider them important, at least in theory, but the reality is that not all data vendors monitor these variables enough to fully address them and follow the trifecta of data quality management. To put a dollar figure on why data veracity is important, the IBM Big Data and Analytics Hub estimates poor data costs the US economy alone $3.1 trillion every single year. Let that sink in for a second. That's a lot of money. Data veracity is important. Thank you to the sponsor of this video, Dataedo. Dataedo allows you to catalog, document, and understand your data with a data dictionary, business glossary, and ER diagrams. Go get a free trial and check them out for yourself. Additionally, use the following coupon code for a 10% discount on your purchase. The links are in the video's description, so start boosting your data and software initiatives today. Don't forget to check out LightsOnData.com. Here you can find more informative content such as templates and guides, best practices, articles, and other useful resources to help you with your data governance and data management questions and challenges. Please like the video if you've enjoyed it, and don't forget to subscribe to never miss out on great content. Thank you. Chocolate?